أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا يرشدا. الصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا العبد المعيد والرسول المسدد المحمود الأحمد حبيبنا وحبيب إله العالمين أبو القاسم المصطفى محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. اللهم صل على محمد وعلي وفاطمة والحسن والحسين وتسعة المعصومين من ذرية الحسين عليهم السلام. اللهم عجل في فرج مولانا صاحب الأسر والزمان. عباد الله اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. قال الحكيم في قرآن الكريم إن الأرض لله يورثها من يشاء والعاقبة للمتقين. صدق الله العلي العظيم. Alhamdulillah that with all the difficulties that we have in our life, the final analysis is, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that finally العاقبة للمتقين. The final analysis is that the متقين, those that they are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be successful. This success is guaranteed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how does it come? It is the taqwa that is a part of every Muslim, is a part of us, as it is a part of Jum'ah, to elaborate on that concept. If you have taqwa, you will be totally under the command of Allah. And therefore the difficulties is no longer difficulties, nor the setback is a setback. It is all for the better future that we have. In beautiful hadith that we have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you are a man of taqwa, then he tells us, لَا تُعْسَنِي وَلَا تَسْأَلِ الْمَغْفَرَةِ. Don't make sin. For the muttaqi, they will not make sin. What is sin? Not to be obedient to Allah's command. What is sin? To follow the shaitan, not to follow the path of Allah. Where is shaitan? In my own nafs, in my own desire. What does he want me to do? Be against the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So anytime that I recognize myself and I do go against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of the shaitana of me, one shaitan of my nafs is telling me, do what you're supposed to do, and I have to prevent it, not to let it happen. لَا تَعْسَنِي وَلَا تَسْأَلِ الْمَغْفِرَةِ. Don't make usyan, don't make sin, and then say, Allah forgive me. Recognize who I am. Then it says in the Yabna Adam, أَنَا رَاضٍ بِسَلَبَاتِكَ يَوْمًا فَيَوْمًا فَرْضَ أَنِّي بِقُوتِكَ يَوْمًا فَيَوْمًا. My people, Allah subhanahu is talking to us so beautifully, the way that he puts it. My people, Yabna Adam, or the children of Adam, I am happy of you with your salat every day that you make salat. Be happy of me every time that I'm giving you your food. Do we know that the food belongs to Allah? Do we know that the air belongs to Allah? The earth belongs to Allah? Whatever that we have belongs to Allah. One of the greatest scholars that I was in his presence, a child came, or a young man came, and he says, I have his pictures with me. I give it to you. Ask him to write an advice for me under his own picture. So I gave it to that scholar, which was Imam Khomeini Rizwanullah Alayh. And he wrote back. And he says, whatever that you have belongs to Allah. Put whatever that you have on the path of Allah. Therefore, you will never be wrong. Therefore, he says in that one, that Yabna Adam, Radin Besalabatika Yoman Fayoma, Fardani Bagotika Yoman Fayoma. I am happy of your salat every day that you make salat. Be happy of me every day that I give you the food, day by day. Every time that you are thirsty, the food that it comes to you is a rain from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that it is poured down in the ground and you take it. یا ابن آدم مهلا فإن الرزق مقسوم والحریث و محروم. The food that we have on the earth is big enough to have food for all of us, wherever that we are. The one that it is really harith, harith is someone that it is greedy and he wants everything for himself. He is deprived of that from such a deprivation. Why is it? Every time that every step that you take on the earth, this earth is the mean of sustenance for all of us. And it is feeding us. Therefore, don't take more than what you are on it. Unfortunately, many of the problems and difficulties that is in our own mind, in our community, in our society, a person that it is haris or is greedy, he accumulates much more than he can even bear. He says, don't put a spoon of food in your mouth that you cannot chew. But unfortunately, human is not like the way that it is. And he says, فَإِنَّ الرِّزْقْ مَقْسُومٌ. The rizq, the mean of sustenance, is divided amongst you. Allah subhanahu has the ground, the earth, enough for everybody to live on it and live out of it. وَالْحَرِيثُ مَحْرُومٌ. Those that they are greedy, they are deprived of the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? If it is a part of the earth that it belongs to all of us, the moment that you take away from somebody else's and don't give it to him, and that is why we have all of this starvation, all of the poverties, all of the needies that we have. That's why we have the Myanmars and all of the people that they are starving to death is due to that greed that some other people have. Wal hasidu madhmum wa ni'matu la yadum. The one that it is jealous, the one that it is greedy and he adds the money for himself, didn't give it to the others, is actually is down and doom. And then this blessing of Allah will never be all the time for you. Because a day is going to come that you are asking Allah, I want to return, but it is too late. يَبْنَا عَدَمَ اسْتَحْكِمْ سَفِينَتِكَ فَإِنَّ الْبَحْرِ عَمِيقٌ عَمِيقٌ. O children of Adam, make your boat or whatever that you have, make it safe for yourself. Why? This sea that you are on it, which is the life that we are living on it, this sea is deep and deep, and the depth of it is much more than you can think of. Make sure that you are really doing what you are supposed to do. Tomorrow is too late, in other words. As much as you can right now, there is no way that you can guarantee you will be tomorrow. And as we read in the beautiful du'a of the Sha'baniyah, in the salawat of Sha'baniyah, he says, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, al-fulkil jariyah fil-lujajil ghamirah ya'manu man rakabaha wa yaghraqu man tarakaha. This fulkil jariyah is Ahlul Bayt. The way that they are giving you the guidelines, Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, is both of them together. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam receives a message from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from Jibreel alayhi salam, and continuation of that resala to the wilaya, which is both together, Muhammad wa ala Muhammad, this wav is connecting them together. He says, stick to both of them. Stick to the last Ala Muhammad today that we are calling it, Imam Mahdi Ajalallah Ta'ala. Every time that you are living, there is one Ala Muhammad in our life. After Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the first Ala Muhammad, Imam Ali Alayhi Salam, and the last Ala Muhammad, as we are all waiting for him, is Imam Mahdi Ajalallah Ta'ala Farajul Sharif. So it is called Al-Fulk Al-Jariyah. They are really, you have to go ahead and get guideline from them. Guideline of Quran is always with you and among you and with you. Go ahead and get the guideline. Be on the ship of the safety of this Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. Al-Fulk Al-Jariyah, Fil-Lujaj Al-Ghamirah. It is in this deep sea that it is so wavy. Ya'manu man rakabaha wa yaghraqu man tarakaha. The one that it is in the boat is safe to the shore of the safety. The one that is not is going to be drowned. And it's called it as mutaqaddimu lahum zahiq. المتقدم لهم مارق والمتأخر عنهم زالق واللازم لهم لاحق. The one that it is in front of it is really going down the sea, is not going to be safe. The one that is behind it, too far away, is going to get lost. He won't find the ship anymore. با but the one that is with them are saved. Lahiq. So Allah, I mean, this beautiful hadith, that it is hadith of Qudsi, astahkam safinatan fa innal bahr amiqun amiq wa akthar min azad fa innal aqabata kawudun kawud. Make sure that you have enough for yourself in this life, because this aqaba, this road that it is deep and very scary, is difficult to pass on. The life that we are living, my brothers and sisters, is not just the life of I, me, myself. The life of me, myself, is not the human ways. It is our life. It is the connection of us to the rest of the humanity. Connection of the rest of the humanity to the earth, and the earth that is connected to heaven above. Accept that it is one unit. خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ نَفْسٍ وَاحِدًا. Created you from one nafs, one deed. Why is it? Without others, I cannot exist. I have to have the means of all of these facilities that is existing is because of the others. All of that is created. And the others have to live on the earth, that is the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the earth without the heaven is impossible to be the earth. Earth needs the heaven. Earth needs the sun and the moon and the day and the rain and clouds and all of the benefits that is come from the heaven, so the earth become whatever it is supposed to be. Therefore, be a part of the whole creation so you will be saved. Otherwise, separation, I, me, myself, does not exist in the dictionary of humanity. In al-ab ya'mal fi dunya hatra yadrikhu al-maut fayandam ala ma salafa min ad-dunub wal-khataya. Man is doing continuously what is in dunya. Dunya, dunya, dunya. I have to run, I have to do this. Why don't you come to masjid? I don't have time. Why don't you make salat? I have exam. Why don't you do the right things? I don't want to do that. And all of these things is a part of, unfortunately, the busy life that we have. And then, finally, the day is going to come that we can't do much. And then what happened? Whatever that I left, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَيَسْأَلُ الرَّجْعَةَ إِلَى الدُّنْيَا فَلِيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا. So I'm asking, Ya Allah, return me back to dunya, so I do something that it is right. عَمَلْ صَالِحَا. Well, this is sometimes, is ayat of the Quran that it says, كَلَّا. It is too late. Whatever that you are doing, do it now. Tomorrow is too late. رَبَّنَا أَبْسِرْنَا فَرْجَعْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحَا نَمُغَنُونَ. Return me. I believe now. It is too late to believe now. Rabban enna yughanun. Now I have a yaqeen that I know today that I should have done whatever that I have done today. Return me back so I do whatever that I can do. Fa ba'izzati wa jalali ya araddu ahadan abada. By my might and by my, he's swearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his jalala, that no one is going to be returned. Let us look at ourselves. Each and every one of us, that we have gone to the cemetery, we have seen someone that is buried down there. It is in the casket, or then they put it down into the vault, which is way down there in the ground. Then finally it is covered up. Then return me. Who is going to help you if you were not with human being? Who is going to help you to dig down the ground and make sure that you are coming down and you are talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because you were not with everybody else's. You were alone by yourself. And that is what it says, that for izzati wa jalali la araddu ahadan abada. No one is going to be returned back to the earth. It is finished, and my total folder is in three pieces of my coffin, that it is with me and it is tied down. And when they put me into the grave, they untie it. They said, the rest of it is up to you, Ya Allah. You have heard this beautiful hadith that it says a man, when he passes away, all of his families, the loved ones and the friends and everybody comes under his casket and bring him to the gravesite. This is what we can do. What else can we do? Nothing. All of his wealth is going to come to him, and he says, this is what I can do. Find you a gravesite, a coffin, and it may be some expenses for whatever that whoever has washed your body and this and that, that one. Then my action is going to come and stay with me. He says, I'm going to be with you forever. My wealth doesn't do any good to me. my friends and relatives and the son and the nothing can do good to me. What I have done is the issue. On that time, it is too late to come back. من سرني واتقى مني أعطيته جنة. The one that he says makes me happy in this dunya, okay, my happiness, the reward of him is Jannah, a paradise on the life of hereafter. Life of hereafter. Inshallah ta'ala. He says, how do you make me happy? And rather than salawatika yawman fa yawma. I'm happy with your salawat, with your prayer. Day by day prayer. Do your prayer. Then farzanni biqutika yawman fa yawma. Then be happy of me every day that I give you food. Every day that you're eating. You eat your breakfast. You're going to eat your lunch. You're going to eat your dinner. Be happy of what I'm giving it to you. I'm happy of you. And it is ayat of the Quran. Radiallahu anhum. Why? Dalika liman khashiya rabbah. Allah is happy of you. You are happy of you. Why? You're fearful. Allah, I don't want to do anything that it is not the way that you want me to do. Then it goes on. Kam min faqirin. Kam min faqirin. Qad taraka naqdahu fi ad-dunya wa kharaja minha ila al-akhirati masruran mashkura. So many poor people. Poor according to what? Not according to billions and billions and billions and adding to the billion. So many of people that they don't have money. Whatever that they had, they spend it in this dunya. And for the life of hereafter, and the life of hereafter, masroor, and not only he's happy, he's thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the great reward that you have given to me. And then the opposite. Kam min ghaniyan قد ترك ماله في الدنيا وخرج منها الى الاخره وهو فقير وحيد. So much of the rich people that they didn't spend their money in this dunya. They spend their money in this dunya, nothing for akhira. And when they get to the akhira, they are faqir, they are poor and alone by himself. Poor and alone. Why? Because if you were with the others, you would have helped the others. If you were with the other people, فَدْخُلِ فِي عِبَادِي وَدْخُلِ جَنَّ. Be a part of the problem of my ummah. Then you will enter to my paradise. I don't care about the others. I don't care about Palestine. I don't care about the Myanmar. I don't care about the problems of the ummah. That is not the human being. Our hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. مَنْ أَسْبَحَ وَلَمْ يَهْتَمَّ بِأُمُورِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ فَلَيْسَ بِمُسْلِمٍ. If you don't care about the others' problem, you are not a Muslim. You have to see what's going on, and I'm a part of it, and inshallah, I will do what I can do. And then, بله و هو فقیر و هی من ماله و نادم على عمله. And then he is unhappy of what he has done. The billions of trillions of dollars. Ask somebody of himself, what are you going to do with it? How much of it can you take to your grave? Fill it up with what? It doesn't matter how much you, what are you going to do with it? If you are not spending it for the rest of the humanity and you are adding to your wealth, then finally, that is on the day of judgment, nadimun ala amalih. So pleased with whatever he has done. وَجَمَعَهُ مَالُهُ لِوَارِثِهِ وَكَانَ أَشَدَّ النَّاسِ عَذَابًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. He left it for the future people. And future people gain it for the future. Then there is a severe punishment. Why did you deprive all of the blessing that I have for you and didn't give it to the others? So on the day of judgment, you will be asked from the ni'mah. On that day, you are going to ask, what did you do with the blessing that I gave it to you? I accumulated it. I left it. I didn't want to spend it. The problem of the others, I didn't care. Problem that the Myanmar or wherever that they are having all of those people, that they are starving to death, I didn't care. Well, if you didn't care for them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not have any reward. So on that day, زدناهم عذابا فوق العذاب بما كانوا يكسبون. The punishment on top of the punishment is for them, for whatever that they have done. We are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this blessed month of Sha'ban, that it is more than half is past, make us to be of those that we care for our ummah. We care for each other. May Allah be pleased with those that they are among us actually. Every day Allah is witnessing. They are always in my prayer, if inshallah Allah accept it. What do? They are planning for the life of hereafter continuously. Their times, their efforts. Why? That dunya is not at all going to be stopped by my death. It's a new beginning for the life of hereafter. What is wrong with me that I'm not connecting this life to the life of hereafter? And if I do that, then on the Yawm al-Qiyamah, that is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an. Allah is happy of you, you are happy of Allah. Dhalika bima khashiya. Because of the khashiya and the fear that, ya Allah, I know I have a responsibility and duty. I know the Holy Quran is my manual. I know the Holy Quran is my constitution. It is my law book of how to live by myself, how to live with other human being, how to live with my environment, and how to follow your command, inshallah ta'ala. With that, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us and help us to be what He wants us to be rather than what we want to be. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. قل هو الله احد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا احد ادعوا الله سبحانه وتعالى وان شاء الله انتم يوقنون باجابه
ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار
الله سلام بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه الحمد لله الأول بلا أول كان قبله والحمد لله الآخر بلا آخر يكون بعده والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم اللهم صل على محمد وعلي وفاطمة والحسن والحسين وتسعة المأسومين من ذرية الحسين عليهم السلام اللهم أجل في فرج مولانا صاحب الأسر والزمان الله سبحانه is giving us the guideline من يطع الله والرسول فأولئك ما الذين أنعم الله عليهم the four group من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا The one that is obeying Allah and His Messenger. Allah and messengers are together always. Messenger is the message that he brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This message is the messenger also. The message and messengers are together with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then you will be of those that Allah subhanahu had blessed them of all these groups that they are going to be. Don't you want to be of one of these groups? Inshallah ta'ala, we want to be all of them. من النبيين those that they bringing the news to the others because you obeyed Allah and His Messenger والصديقين and those that they are truthful people which are of course all of them falls into the categories of آل محمد والشهداء those that they are really witnessing in the life of hereafter as well as in this life they became martyr والصالحين and the righteous people And وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا And such a beautiful friendship is with them. Who are those and أَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ Every day, of course today you are going to make salat, inshallah ta'ala, that رَبَّنْ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ And who are those people that أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ On صراط المستقيم أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ صِرَاطِكَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ It is a ni'mah of accepting Muhammad وآل محمد. اللهم صل على محمد. This ni'mah is guiding us continuously to the betterment of our life. Our Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away 1400 years ago. Is it finished and over? No, it is passed on to all Muhammad. All Muhammad is connected to Muhammad until the day of judgment. How many times we have heard this ahadith that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, "Inni tarikum fikum thaqalain," I'm leaving with you these two valuables, two great weight that you have in your life. What are these two great ways? One is Kitab Allah, and this is a Hablullah al-Mateen, the book of Allah, the Holy Quran, that is extended from as far as the heaven goes, and the owner of the heaven, down to the earth. This is Hablullah. This is a context of you to stick to that rope until you get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the second part is, wherever that the Quran does not have illustration in it, it is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know that Quran is a word. Salat is an act. When you go to Hajj, your ihram is an act. Your tawaf is a Hajj. Your sa'i is a Hajj. Is the action. All of those actions that it is in your system, it is by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, you have to follow Quran and the Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, that is continuation of and Risala of Rasulullah to Walaya of Al Muhammad, inshaAllah ta'ala. Elahi wa Rabbi, as this blessed month of Sha'ban is with us, make us the rest of the month to follow you, to become close enough to you that inshaAllah when the month of Ramadan comes, I'm in totality with you. The month of Sha'ban is the month of Rasulullah, the month of Ramadan is Shahrullah. Bless us so when we come to Shahrullah, in totality, day and night, I'm mixed with your command and whatever that you want me to be. Mansur al-Islam wa al-Muslimin. Allahumma ansur man nasar al-Din. Allahumma ansur juyush al-Muslimin wa asakir al-Muwahideen. Wakhdur al-Kuffar wa al-Munafiqin wa al-Mustakbirin wa al-Mushrikin. Washfi mardana wa arham mautana sallim dinana wa dunyana. Ibadallah. Inna Allah ya'muru bil adli wal ihsan wa itazi al-ghurba. وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون قوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.